the show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
And we remind you to please drive home safely.
As the sun begins to descend toward the desert floor. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Jared Cannon is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. Well, guys, you take a look at this Diamondback squad as they begin play here tonight. They were finally able to snap that long losing streak last time out. A rare bright spot in what's been a horribly difficult stretch.
Yeah, Maddie, the first game of any series is super important. You have a chance to set the tone, whether it's three-game set or a four-game set. You take the...
Well, the left fielder's on it, and that retires the side. Three up, three down for San Diego. And now Arizona gets... Stepping in is Jared Cannon. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. De La Cruz goes to get it, and the throw is made to record the second out of the inning. Next up, Jared Cannon. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
That evens it up, 1-1. Now the pitch. And it's 1-2.
This is why you pay the price of admission right here. Power on power. My money's on the pitcher.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Down the left field line and deep. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So one run here. On one base hit, the home run. Next to hit is Jared Cannon, 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. He's set and the pitch.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
A ball and a strike to the Padres first baseman. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Weak grounder down the first baseline. And this is going to work out for him. It's an infield single to make it first and second now. Now at the plate, Will Myers. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point.
The right fielder, Will Myers.
Grounded weakly to the left. Scooped up to second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. So no runs on a hit here, no errors. One. Tonight, Arizona jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Adrian Morejon takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, not a surprise for this time of year. It is burning hot here at Chase Field in Phoenix. Today, the finale of this three-game weekend series between the San Diego Padres and the Arizona Diamondbacks. It's Diamondbacks baseball next on the show. Luke Weaver, a right-hander from Florida, gets the ball as the starter here. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
One of the things that jumps in.
Next, it'll be Jared Cannon. Two hits and eight tries for the series.
One time, right now. Kid. Here we go.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Well, guys, these Diamondbacks, as they begin play, they do come in off a victory last time out, but they've really hit the skids here recently. Losers of eight of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, without question. They find themselves in this position today. They got a chance to sweep the series on Sunday and make it a miraculous weekend.
Boy, D-Roy, it's always a nice way to finish off a weekend. You win a big game on Saturday, and to close it off with a win here and a sweep on Sunday would really be sweet for this ball club.
Popped him up. Geraldo has got it, and the side is retired. One left for San Diego. Next up is Jared Cannon. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss, 0-1.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Padres leave a pair. Home half of the third coming. Next to stand in is Jared Cannon, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. A ball and no strikes.
Well, they've yet to hang a number on the scoreboard, but it looks like they've got a great opportunity from the breakthrough. Going to be pretty demoralizing if they can't.
A 1-0 delivery. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss.
Wow, the Padres have been scuffling so far. They need to get a big hit, and it's about time somebody comes through right about now.
And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. And the runner will score from second. He pulls into third safely as we're now tied after a pair of runs score on the play.
Yeah, when that left his bat, I thought it was out of here for a three-run shot, but to his credit, he didn't hesitate or break into that home run trot. He busted it out of the box and was thinking triple all the way. Well done.
The 1-2. Hit to third. He's got it. Ah, but the throw pulls him off the bag as he can't get a foot back in time, and the run will score. So here is Jared Cannon. Two RBIs already, looking for more here. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Lifted down the line and left. Lofted in the air out to right field. Long run for the right fielder. He's there to track it down, and that'll end. Set to start the ninth in this one, and here comes the first baseman, Jared Cannon. Now the pitch. Back up the middle. That's through for a base hit, his second of the ball game. With that, the inning opens with the Padres getting their leadoff man on base.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
A 1-1 home. Pitch is high. The throw. And it skips in as he steals the bag easily.
That's a swipe of the bag. And this catcher, he throws really well, too. So that's not easy. Good job there by the base runner.
This is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Stepping in next, Brian O'Grady, runner in scoring position with Sugan. Left side, fielded cleanly. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Padres leave one, but they hold a 9-2 lead. A 9-2 finish at the end. The weekend is on deck, and so is nighttime baseball from Petco Park in San Diego's Gaslamp District. Tonight, it's baseball on the show, and it's coming. Joe Musgrove will be the man on the. And now, Jared Cannon. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. He's set. Here it comes. And he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. Center fielder looking up, and it's gone.
Boy, not the way you'd like to start a game, right? First inning you come in.
Three. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Jared Cannon. Off to a fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at-bat, so there's got to be a good chance they mix it up right here on him and try and go off speed.
Ortega is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are... Jared Cannon will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. From the stretch, just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. The 1-0, a swing and a miss, strike one.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slider looked like a heater for about 56 feet 6 inches.
Count is 1-2 now. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. Rodriguez finds it. The throw to first is in time, one down. Next to hit, Jared Cannon struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Jared Cannon.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Swing hard liner to left center. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
Boy, Dero, there's a case of the outfield defense playing so deep that that ball looked like it was extra bases all the way, but they were able to cut it off.
Yeah, not too many times, I would agree. I'd love to hear your take on this as well. The no doubles defense, I kind of never understood it to begin with. I felt like the pitcher, if he can execute the game plan, could keep the ball in front of the outfielders, but right there, boy, I was wrong. That worked.
Comes set with the 0-1. Popped him up. Right fielder coming on. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. And certainly no chance of scoring him there. It's a missed opportunity, and there's one gone in the inning now.
The right fielder.
Here's
number
Will Myers.
Four.
Both teams with 6 hits so far.
Fire.
And the slider gets him swinging. 2 gone. And with strike 3 recorded there, he's notched his first career major league strikeout.
Well, Matt, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have at least one pitch that they can go into in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
Throw over to the bag, and he is tagged out here. Boy, a bad mistake that time as he's picked off to end the inning. One hit, one left. Ninth inning coming up. Padres lead it. Tonight's ball game comes to a close 3-1 the final. San Diego get their 20th home win this year. Joe Musgrove earns his 6th winning decision in this one. Edwin Diaz closes the door for the save, his 18th. It's a typically clear and beautiful day in San Diego as we get set for afternoon baseball from Petco Park. Today, it's game 2 of a 3-game weekend. Mackenzie Gore will be on the bump for game 2 of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be exciting. This is one of the top young pitchers.
And it'll be the cleanup spot for the Padres, Jared Cannon. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no strikes. And guys, as we take a look at the Pirates coming into this afternoon, they came out on the losing end last time out and are in a bit of a skid. In fact, they've lost 7 of their last 10.
Yeah, guys, dropping yesterday was a heartbreaker without question. But you know what? You find a way. You show up to the yard today, you get out of the cab, and you watch countless hours of video, and you try and formulate a game plan to get this back to 500. 1-1 to start the road trip, and you're moving in the right direction.
Fouled off. And another foul ball. Grisham over at second. Tatis is over at first with one away. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. And that'll drop into no man's land out there for a base hit. To second now, but he's safe as they also push across a score to make it a 1-run game.
Just a great at-bat there. That one-out double gets a run across, and now they've got runners at second and third and are one solid swing away from making this a real big inning.
Swinging a soft liner. It's flagged down deep in the hole. Throw from shallow right will get him at first, but the run will come in to score.
I like that he didn't try to do too much there. All he needed was a ground ball to tie this thing up, and that's exactly what he does. That's great situational hitting.
Here's Will Myers. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. The 0-2 towards second. And this is taken for the out. I'll give the enthusiasm. Up next for the Buccos, Juan Rodriguez grounded out in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at-bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
On to first, a double play. And now here is Jared Cannon. He doubled his last time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
And he sends it the other way toward right center. Right fielder giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. Ready now is Jared Cannon. He'll do battle with a new arm out there in their half of the sixth. First pitch of the AB now. Hit hard to third. And a sliding effort there, but that ball had eyes and the leadoff man's on base to start the inning. So he finds the hole into left to pick up his second base hit of the afternoon. And you see there, he's currently in second place on the Friars in that category. Now to bat, Manny Machado. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. On to first to complete the double play. Now with the plate is Jared Cannon trying here to plate the tying run from second.
All right, take a look here. We need you. Let's go.
first delivery to him. Couldn't resist on that one, and he's behind nothing and one.
Wow, the Padres have been scuffling so far. They need to get a big hit, and it's about time somebody comes through right about now.
A ball and a strike to the Padres' first baseman.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two.
I understand wanting to be aggressive, but I also understand that you can occasionally be foolish. That's a foolish swing right there. This guy has been struggling to find the zone, and you might have just bailed him out.
Madrigal, the runner at third. Grisham is over at second with one down in the inning. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Left fielder is on the move. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And the run is in to score from third. A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. The Pittsburgh Pirates took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Mitch Keller with his fourth win this season as he gives up only two hits in five innings of work. Mackenzie Gore was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. Nothing like a warm summer afternoon at Petco Park in San Diego. Today it's the rubber match of this three-game series between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the San Diego Padres. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Brian Farley, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do you have for us?